the DJ plays our song so you can find me and dance behind me.
Down the line.
You love how I dip and wine. With you it happens every time. My body's lonely for you only. Something about you got me sweating, sweating. Baby, I'ma drive you loco, loco. Now you got my body shaking, shaking. Hey. I wanna dance with you all night.
Hey DJ, póngale la música que le gusta. Una para que se mueva y se luzca. Y baile conmigo, solo conmigo.
Hey. Okay, basically this is the background of the company. In December 2006, Bob Prestos with his Blue Ridge Mail controller intended to add a new on-site longwood yard. Basically, this company processed a wood yard for their revenue. Okay, the current process that they've been running is acquire short wood and they have to purchase from their competitor, which is Shenandoah Mail. What is the new process? Okay, this is the new process. They can get long woods, which is they can allow a tree line wood or long wood to be processed directly. Okay. First, to eliminate the need to purchase short wood from outside supplier, so they don't have to rely on Shenandoah Mill. Be able to reduce cost and increase revenue. If they do not rely on Shenandoah Mill, they will reduce the cost. Okay. The third one creates the opportunity to sell short wood on the open market as a new market for them. So they can compete with Shenandoah Mill. So the issue is whether this benefit were enough to justify the $18 million capital outlay plus the incremental investment in working capital over the 6-year life of the investment.
Because from the WACC, the company can make investment decision and can know the whether the project is similaries or dissimilaries. So first, from the case, the case didn't mention any ratio for debt and equity. So when we want to find the WACC, we must find the ratio for debt and equity first. So this is the formula for ratio debt and ratio equity. So we get the ratio debt is 5.88% and ratio equity is 11.2%. After that, the ratio debt and ratio equity, we can find the WACC and follow the formula. We get the WACC is 9.7%. After we get the WACC, next we can proceed to calculate the NPV, IRR and MIRR.
$10 million.
negative 3 million and EBIT before tax in 2008 is negative 2000 and 2009 and in 2013 is 2.5 million. For a tax is 40% in 2008 80,000 and 2009 and in 2013 is 1 million. So we got a net income. The income from 2008 is negative 280,000 and 2009 and in 2013 is 1.5 million. So we plus depreciation 3 million and we got operation cash flow in 2008 is 2.88 million and 2009 and in 2013 is 4.5 million. So we must got a net cash flow in 2007 is negative 60 million and 2008 480,000, 2009 3.9 million and 2010 is 4.5 million, 2011 4.5 million, 2012 is 4.5 million and 2013 is 6.58 million.
Give you what you want, you want, you want. But you gon' fall in love, in love, in love. So
on the calculation of net cash flow and the PACC before this, we prepare the timeline of the project. So from here we calculate the net present value to know whether we can get positive or negative return from the project. So here are the NPV value, which is $820,730. It shows positive return, so we can accept the project. Besides, we calculate internal rate of return to measure the rate of return from the project. So here are the IRR of the project, 11.07%. It shows it higher than WACC, so we can accept the project.
What you want, you want, you want, cause you gon' fall for me, baby.
After we calculate the NPV and IRR and WACC, we can calculate MIRR, where the formula is initial investment equal to FV over MIRR plus 1 the power of N. So first we need to calculate FV, where we just take from the year first. Don't take the from the zero, because zero will be the answer. So after we get the NPV, we total up, and then we get MIRR 10.59%.
Yo me imagino.